Welcome to another very serious and informative video as we try and move out of our coma. We're in an incredible coma of forgetfulness, actually. And I tried my very best today, and I had a very incredible day, actually. Not from progress, but from resistance. And I got to experience firsthand the extremely tough, incredible resistance that I met. So, in that way, it was a very interesting day. I'd never experienced anything like this before. I tried to use the theme of, I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. Simple enough, right? But I found it getting more and more and more difficult during the day, to the point where I was not even able to say it. I had just tremendous, like, brain freeze and frustration and just struggle, immense struggle. I kept inverting it and using different terms. I couldn't say it. It was just an amazing battle. I kept trying to find tricks to, how can I do it? So if my mind would stray, I'd say, not practicing. Why are you not practicing? I'd say this to myself. Why am I not practicing? Oh, I'm concerned about what survival issue. Okay, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And the solution to the continuity problem is the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness, the location of this camera doesn't matter. This camera spaciousness as it is now, is that. I am that. This is that. That now refers to pure spaciousness, God, pure spaciousness. So, all day long the battle's been going on, and it still is. There's some kind of really deep-seated resistance. And I find my thoughts straying. It's always about some survival issue. Like, how can we fight to survive? How can we survive? How can we survive? Our thoughts are preoccupied with survival. And so, we're so used to this that in trying to actually turn around the entire situation of emphasis, I found that it became very, very bloody and difficult. We have a storm here in California. What is that? It's been like almost 400 days since we've had a real storm. So, going to be a little noisy here. So I have not surmounted this problem yet, but it's interesting that I had this guru figure in a morning dream yesterday, who said something about there is no survival problem. There is not, and then gave me a whole bunch of ways to say it in this dream. And that I've been trying it ever since and having very much difficulty trying to do it. Obviously, this is a core issue. And no wonder why this is so difficult. If we don't have the basics down really well, this is just going to be too much. We're going to get too frustrated. It's a deep-seated kind of resistance. I'm trying to, like, dig it out. It's like doing a root canal. Our mind is preoccupied with survival beliefs and considerations and concepts and thoughts. Really preoccupied. Very preoccupied. It's in a coma. It's in a survival coma. And I say, I don't have a survival problem. No survival problem. Nobody, I've never had a survival problem and never will have a survival problem. Don't have one now. There is no such thing as a survival problem. And this is true. But just try and continue on in this way, and you will find out that your mind will become muddled, you'll go off track. This is the teeth of meditation. Most people think meditation is like sitting down in some kind of yogic posture in your nice yoga clothes with some nice soothing music, a little bit of incense, a flower, and breathing, relax. Relax. Think good thoughts. Okay. What we're doing here is something, off the charts as far as traction effectiveness goes. And this is, I call, real meditation, in that you experience this incredible, desperate egoic resistance. So what I did was, I figured out this is the way to do it. When you meet this resistance, you say, why am I not practicing? Why am I not practicing? I'm preoccupied with survival thoughts. Let's just say it. Why am I not practicing? Preoccupied with survival thoughts. Oh, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. But somehow I think there's another word that I should be using for survival, or maybe it's just irritation with this. It's a battle. Why am I not practicing? I'm preoccupied with survival thoughts. Oh, I don't have a survival problem. Oh, yeah, I have a continuity problem. I don't have any survival problem. Never have and never will have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem, though. And the resolution is the vision of oneness. How do I get that? By practicing. This spaciousness is that. This spaciousness, as it is now. This plant, as it is now. This plant, as it is now. This area, as it is now. Practice, practice, practice. Obviously, the guru, the inner guru, knows that this survival issue is paramount, and said, tackle this one. You're doing great, but now try this one. And I found out it's very tough. My second day of struggling with this. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. The difficulty is during the daytime, when you're driving, when you're talking, you're working, you're interacting, eating, preparing food, everything you're doing, your mind just takes off, and you forget all about it, and then you try to bring yourself back, and it's like you're all flustered. It's like you go back into a coma. When bringing people out of a coma is often done very slowly, and it can take a long time actually to fully come out of a coma. And what happens is sometimes there's an awakening, partial awakening, and then the person goes back into the coma. They might open their eyes and tend to interact a little bit, open your eyes, close your eyes, squeeze my hand, and say, oh, they're coming out of the coma, and then they go back into it. So I really liken our situation to someone coming out of a coma, and that I made great headway last week. And then suddenly I feel this tremendous resistance, like it's trying to pull me back into the coma. It's like, wow, what happened? So it's a slow process, and you go forward and you go back, go forward and go back. And what is it that's holding us in this coma? Survival thoughts, how do I survive? How do I survive? How do I survive? Survival thoughts. There's never ever been a survival problem at all. There's nothing. How could God have a survival problem? Is there something separate from God? No, then how can there be a survival problem? A survival problem is a game we're playing. We're playing a survival game, like a video game. And this planet is really where people go, where we go to play the survival game. Can we, how do we survive when we're threatened with, our survival is threatened? It's just a game. It's just something we imagine. And yet we're so caught up in it that we don't know how to stop the game. So sometimes someone comes into this world and tries to tell us, you know, how do we drop this stupid survival game? And we have extreme difficulty to do it. But it is literally simply like a virtual reality game that we've invented. It's not true. There's no such thing as any survival being threatened. No one's life is ever threatened at all. Because all life is eternal life. It's all one. It's just one eternal life that is living through so many, many expressions and facets. So we come in here and this world and get caught up, sucked up into this survival game here. And we have to turn this around. Wow, stuff getting blown over right now. Whew. That was a little twig came blowing through here. That was the strongest wind I've felt in a long time, actually, in California. It's been a long time since we felt that powerful wind here. This is actually a storm of some note, which we are somewhat forgotten about here. Wow. Speaking of storms, a big storm is coming to this world for sure. So we have to realize we don't have a survival problem. We only have a continuity problem. That's the only problem we have. We have to drop the survival game. Drop the survival game. It's only a game. It's only a virtual reality like video game we're playing. With these avatars, we have our roles, role playing. We have this body playing a role in the survival game. But there is no survival game anywhere, actually. Just fantasy. And we can see this. I don't see it right now, but I have. There's resistance going on. So there's fierce resistance being put up over this issue. So the best thing to do is just continue on. When you get this fierce inner resistance, realize you're really onto something. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. It's easy to do it when I'm taping, but when I'm not taping, then it gets very difficult. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And I love my continuity problem. I absolutely love it. Just absolutely love it. It's the greatest thing ever. Let's see. That wind is... Yeah. Because the continuity problem brings with it the resolution to the continuity problem. And that is... vision of oneness. That's what solves a continuity problem. So we want to embrace the continuity problem, absolutely. Because then we get to abide in the remedy. The remedy comes with it. The remedy comes with it. So the gist of this video is to talk about the running into some extreme resistance that you didn't expect. And I was literally like almost choking, I had trouble breathing. It was like, I couldn't say the words, survival. I couldn't say it. After I said it, I was like, oh, wow, it was like an incredible internal struggle. Now, my understanding is that our breath, when the ego is in control of our mind, our breath is self-willed kind of breath that we're breathing by the permission of the ego, actually. And that actually there's another way of breathing that doesn't need the ego's permission at all. back in 1978 when I had these episodes of awakening and seeing truth, I saw that our breathing is backwards. We're not being breathed by God. We're trying to breathe ourselves, as it were. And this is essentially, you know, the essential pragmatic issue is our breath, and we're allowing the ego to control our breath, actually. So what I was saying, I don't have any survival problem. I have a continuity problem. It was a battle for my breath, you know, and I could hardly say it because the breath wouldn't say it. I couldn't give breath, you know, speech is breath, right? You're expelling air from the lungs. And I was having a terrible problem to say the word, you know, and just, for, you know, just shaking, and just, it was just such an ordeal. The ego's trying to hold on to my breath, and to control my breath. That's why when we're breathing, everybody, we feel kind of like, or on borrowed time, and the breath is not really ours. There's something around breath that we feel uncomfortable and insecure. We feel there's a survival problem, actually, is what it is. But apparently in releasing the survival problem fantasy, we realize that there's just one cosmic breath and one pure spaciousness, one cosmic breath, and we can never be not have the breath of life. Can never not have the breath of life. It's a whole different change. So the ego is holding on to our breath, doesn't want to lose it, and that's why it's putting up such a battle, and that's why this practice is the battleground. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. It wants to say security, but it's not the same. Security comes easy. Survival comes really difficult to say it. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Yeah, just an inner feeling of inner conflict and turmoil and just strain. There's something really battling against this. I don't have a survival problem. There is no survival problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. That's my only problem. There is no survival problem. There's never been a survival problem. There is no survival problem. This is that. This is that. This is that. I am that. This is that. That is now. That is now. That as it is now. Now as it is that. And this is practicing. But then go back, when your mind strays, go back into the, I don't have a security problem. No, see, I blew it. See what I, wow. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. See, that this is the struggle I've been undergoing all day. I don't have a security problem. Ah! Blew it again. Oh my God. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Whew. Unbelievable. Okay, why am I having trouble practicing? I'm preoccupied with survival thoughts. So I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Wow. That security thing. You see how I tried to get in there? But really, the real thing is not security, because the ego says, I can deal with your security. No problem. No. Survival is what really is driving us, and we don't have a survival problem. Okay? The ego can't really deal with that. You can talk about security all you want, can't you? But survival is a different story. I mean, survival means living or dying, and we all end up dying here. But security is a whole different story, isn't it? So the ego keeps trying to substitute security for... Man, I've never ever had such difficulty on the path. This one is just absolutely amazing. All day I've been working. I'm having trouble here. The ego's happy to help us with security. Oh, you want some security lights? Sure, I'll help you out with security. Why don't we put up a deadbolt? Why don't we do this? See, ego says, see, I took care of your problem. I said, no, wait a minute. Let's talk about survival. Let's talk about, right, surviving, right? I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. So, I'm just sharing firsthand, what's going on, and this is quite amazing. But great, it's great that it seems like I do have some inner guru helping, because what good is it if you don't take up the challenge each day to try and do something, take another step? Obviously, this is a difficult step. So it's got to be challenge helpful. It's got to be helpful. Someone pointed out, hey, this is where you need to look. This is your weak spot. This is your weak spot. Now, that's helpful. Gurus know where your weak spot is. They'll say, hey, this is your weak spot. Work on this one. And you say, I can do the other stuff really good. And the guru says, great. But this one, try this one. And it's shocking. It's really shocking. I can't believe I'm having so much trouble with this. So, why am I not practicing? Preoccupied with survival thoughts. See, I can get that. I'm preoccupied with survival thoughts. Okay, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. So this is a little trick that gets you into it. It's like practicing a musical instrument. You sometimes you have mental blocks, and you need to develop little tricks to get past those blocks. That's those who are really talented have all sorts of little tricks and techniques they're used to get past their mental blocks. And it's like that. It's really like that. People with good memory, too, they have little tricks that help them remember all sorts of stuff, get past the mental block. So this is a mental block. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And I need to practice the vision of oneness, which is, you can say, this table, the location of this table does not matter. This table as it is now. And now is that. I am that. Thatness. Suchness. Thatness. Nowness. I am that. This is that. This is that. This is that. So this is powerful, powerful practice. But what is causing our mind to drift off of this, to stop abiding in this? This is that. God doesn't need any words, doesn't need us to help, any description or words, adding or subtracting, embellishing, nothing. No words are needed whatsoever to abide in that, in suchness, in nowness, in pure spaciousness, in zero dimensionality, pure consciousness, pure awareness, oneness, Christ consciousness, etc. No words are necessary whatsoever. Words actually are part of the survival game, because words can be attacked, right? So it's all part of this. Part of the survival game is using words. And the ego say, well, explain it. And then it starts attacking your explanation, right? Because it's a survival game here. Trying to prove that, that God can die so that we can take over. Heir apparent taking over once God dies. But I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Now, don't be afraid of when the practice suddenly gets tough and you struggle. That's it. Good. Fine. I'm getting into the real teeth of the situation now. That's excellent. I'd just wear it down. I'll start developing little tricks and know how to write myself, you know. It's terrific. Anyone can say, you know, and try to like that, but try saying, I don't have a survival problem. I do not have a survival problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And then try to bring that to mind as you're going about your day and see what happens. And you'll be shocked. You'll be shocked at the difficulty your mind has. And you say, well, wait a minute, where did this difficulty come from? Right? This is something strange. What's wrong with my mind? Something wrong with my mind, obviously. I can't even say something simple like that. What's the problem? Obviously, we have programmed ourselves. We have trained ourselves to think in a certain way that believes in survival problems. Whew. That we have a survival problem. Extremely reinforced that we have a survival problem. Just look at all the movies and television. It's all about survival problems, is it not? As you watch those things, watch that. Don't watch that stuff for sure, but you know that that's what it's about. The issue is survival. What draws us in is survival. Survival. Even in an athletic contest, who's going to survive and who's not? Who's going to win? Who's not? It's survival. It's all about survival, this whole game. And so when you say, I don't have a survival problem, I don't have a survival problem. In fact, I've never had a survival problem, and I never will have one. There is no survival problem. There is no survival problem, plain and simple. That rocks the boat. I mean, that's like abandoning ship. That is really like abandoning ship. And you will find the struggle there. Maybe not initially. I mean, the first time I did, it was easy. But now, you know, it's kind of like they start to bring everything, digging deeper, deeper, deeper. And you find out, no, there's something that just fights tooth and nail against this. Okay, so, now, why am I not practicing? I'm entertaining survival thoughts. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. The only problem there is the continuity problem. It's my only problem, but I'm very grateful. I love my continuity problem because it comes with the remedy. Prepackaged with the remedy, which is the vision of oneness. So I'm preparing for the vision of oneness. This is that. This is that. This is that. The location of this doesn't matter. This is that. The location of this doesn't matter. This is that. This is that. And so I feel really good doing that. And then a couple minutes later, I'm thinking about some survival drama. What? Whoa, wait. And I try to think, why am I not practicing? Preoccupied with survival. Concerns. Oh, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And then get back into the practicing. So, this is what the top gurus demand of those who ask for help. Is this really non-stop practice? And then when you stop practicing, you ask yourself, why do I stop practicing? There's no value in that. There's no value in anything other than vision of oneness. So, if I'm not practicing for the vision of oneness, what am I doing? Preoccupied with survival thoughts. Why am I preoccupied with survival thoughts? I don't have a survival problem. Nobody has a survival problem. So why am I preoccupied with survival thoughts? What value is survival thoughts? What value do they have? Only the vision of oneness has value. Nothing else has value. So these survival concerns have no value. No value whatsoever. We don't have to win the survival game. We just have to leave the survival game. Leaving it is winning. It's the only win there is. Dropping the game and say, this is just completely stupid. There is no survival problem. I don't have a survival problem. The survival problem as it is that. Survival problem as it is now. Survival problem spaciousness is now. Survival problem spaciousness is now. Survival problem spaciousness is that. That, this is that. The location of this that doesn't matter, this is that. The location of this spaciousness doesn't matter. This spaciousness is that, is the one spaciousness. It's all one spaciousness. It's not this spaciousness and then that spacious over there. This is that. Okay, this is that. Very powerful mantra to use. This is that. This is that. That is this. One pure, perfect, uncrystallized, zero-dimensional, formless, attributeless, perfect grounded being. This is that. That is this. This is that. That is this. That tree is this. That tree spaciousness is this. That table spaciousness is this. That light spaciousness is this. That wall spaciousness is this. And this table spaciousness is that. This is that. And that is this. Why am I not practicing? I'm concerned with survival thoughts. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. See, I heard somebody walking on the street. Immediately my mind got preoccupied with survival concerns, and I had a struggle to bring it back. So we start to become aware of how utterly preoccupied we are with survival concerns and how the world indoctrinates us when we come here. And that, I remember as a youth, I didn't have that type of concern, really. I felt very immune to everything. But various events, various things happen that made me preoccupied with survival concerns. Of course, everybody in the world, being totally very much into the survival games, has had a lot to do with that, actually. So I find that when you interact with other people, it becomes very difficult to say this. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. You end up flipping it. So I've been practicing, and I talk to someone else and you know, about work or just some, you know, daily stuff, and suddenly I flipped it and I say, I don't have a continuity problem, I have a survival problem. I say, what? Whoa, wait a minute. How'd that get flipped? Unbelievable. There's no way I can make that kind of mistake. And then here it is, the mistake's right there. So it's the consciousness of people is completely engrossed comatically in survival concerns. Totally engrossed in it. What they're really afraid of is the continuity problem, though. That's what keeps them engrossed in it. But if you recognize and accept you have a continuity problem, then you can come out of your coma and say, I don't need the survival coma. Don't need the survival game. So you will find that you think you're practicing great, and then suddenly, you know, 10 minutes later, you're doing something else, and you've totally forgotten. And you say, what's going on? I'm all, you know, this drama's going on in your mind and in your thoughts. Wow, what's happening? Wait. No. Why am I not practicing? Preoccupied with survival concerns. I'm thinking about survival. Preoccupied with survival concerns. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And that gets you back. And then you build momentum from that. Continuity problem is my only problem. The vision of oneness solves that problem. I love the continuity problem. Just love it, because the vision of oneness comes with it. And I'm practicing now for the vision of oneness. And so this street is that. This street right here, this street as it is that. This street is that. it is the one. This street is the one. This street is the one. The location of the street doesn't matter. This street is the one. This street is that. That building is that. These buildings is. This building space is that. This mountain space is that. This mountain space is that. This is that. This is that. So you start practicing in that way. And very powerful. And you say, great, I got it now. And then, you know, 30 seconds later, you see somebody and you see someone and survival concerns. You've completely forgotten practice. And then when you try to say it, I can't say it. So I'm preoccupied. Why am I not practicing? I'm preoccupied with survival concerns. Oh, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. It's kind of like a swing, a little hitch in your swing to get you going. If you try to just hit from a dead stop, you see the pros, they got there moving a little bit, and they got a little trigger, gets them going, gets the swing going. Well, just like that. You need a little, why am I not practicing? Oh, preoccupied with survival concerns. I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. So, really, we're doing fabulous here. And it's a it is a great blessing, total blessing, to actually have an inner guru that seems to be working with me. Putting me through the paces, saying, do this. That's a great blessing. You just don't hear so much about that now. But when back in the 60s, oh my gosh, it seems like everybody had a guru, and there was all sorts of contact with inner guru. It was just an incredible time. And over the decades, I mean, we're 214 right now. This isn't 1964. 1964, how long ago was that? I mean, was that not 50 years ago? I think that was 50 years ago, right? 50 years, half a century ago, that is unbelievable. No wonder why, to me it's just like yesterday. You know, just like yesterday, I mean, it's still very present in my consciousness that there was so much stuff going on then, so much stuff going on, and just amazing. Tremendous amount of guidance, and people were open to guidance, and gurus and being inspired, and you know, the inner guru, call it whatever you want to, the voice of reason. And now I look around for evidence of stuff, and it's just like, wow, evaporating. So antiquated, you know, 50 years is antiquated, isn't it? I mean, 50 years, you go to an antique shop and you see all sorts of stuff that's 50 years old, even less than that, right? You see a Cabbage Patch doll or something. Oh, man, that's like 30 years ago. I remember the Cabbage Patch doll or something. And by the way, my cabbage are doing great. Unbelievable. They, I guess they don't like much sun. They can do good. The sun is not much sun during winter. They do really good. You just see stuff that you know, this from the 70s. Wow, it's antique stores, 80s even. But you go back to the 60s, a lot, 50s, I mean, those are antiques. I mean, going to see bell bottoms from the 60s, it's like, I remember I went to Army Surplus Store and got these Navy pants, Navy bell bottoms that you know, came from the Navy as surplus, and that was the thing. I mean, I wore those all the time, and that was like completely high fashion. and so now, I mean, try to find a pair of Navy bell bottoms like from the 60s or something. We had to, so all this stuff is very retro, very antique-y now, including having an inner guru. You know, they're very antique-y, very quaint. Like, wow, that's a blast from the past. So it's actually very difficult to accept in the present climate of the world that you have an inner guru, because the people are just not with that. They're just not with it. We gave a great push to the world, and the world pushed back. We basically said, in essence, we say, you know, I am that. You know, this is that. This is that. This is that. And the world said, no, we have survival problems here. And so there was this big pushback, which is why we try to do this now. It's so difficult. It is so difficult. And you don't. I don't expect it to be difficult. I said, "What's going on? What is it? What's so difficult about all this stuff?" Well, it's 2014. We're not in Kansas anymore, and this is the Wild Wild West, to say the least. And it's gotten completely freaky. It's gotten completely freaky, actually. And the effect, just as I experienced the effect of interacting with somebody and it knocks out my practice, just imagine what is knocking out as you go about day after day after day in this climate of civilization we have now in culture, the cultural climate, and the whole situation of the world and the advertising and the news and how everything's going on, how we're being manipulated. Just imagine what an impact that's having on us now. People complain about secondhand smoke, understandable, cigarettes, pot, cigars, you know, whatever smoke, you know, someone's smoking, it goes in the air and we breathe it in. We don't want the smoke inside of us. So secondhand smoke, it should be a no-no, right? Well, what about secondhand behavior? Well, for instance, like inebriated people. They say people are very inebriated. They do, you know. What about their behavior? How does that impact us? You know, smoke, we say smoke impacts us, you know, physically. It's not good for our physical organisms. Well, how about the spiritual organism, as it were? Not that we have a survival problem. We don't. But as far as belief system, how does it affect our belief system? The belief system that we do have a survival problem. How does it affect that? How about very inebriated people then drinking, and the way they act? I always hated inebriated people, the way they acted. I didn't want to be around them because it had a severe impact upon me when I was young. I said, wow, you know, this is terrible. And actually, my parents kept us away from secondhand smoke, from smokers, from all drinkers. We didn't drink, no one in our family drank at all. There's no alcohol in the house. We didn't socialize with any drinkers at all, or smokers, or any. So we tried to stay away from those influences because they're very negative influences, actually. So we're banning secondhand smoke. How about banning secondhand behavior? Isn't that injurious? Maybe more so than secondhand smoke, actually. Probably a lot more so. Secondhand behavior. Yeah, how does that affect people? So the ego doesn't get around to that, you know. But in the same society, of course, you limit the detrimental sort of secondhand and, you know, the overall cultural milieu. That's something that is looked at as far as affecting our practices. Our practice is super important. We don't want to make it more difficult. But right now it's actually very difficult. But there's no excuse not to do it. We have to do it. But I'm seeing, wow, people's minds are really gone. They're really gone. They're in a deep coma. They're in a severe survival coma. They're afraid if they wake up, they'll die. They won't. They'll wake up into bliss. They'll wake up into that. That-ness, suchness, isness, nowness, oneness. Complete unconcern with any survival issue. There is no survival issue. Where can God go to not survive? Where can everywhereness go to not survive? There's some place they can go to hide. I found a place where I can not survive. And if everywhereness, there isn't any such place, of course. Then, and everywhereness is everywhere, then we must be in everywhereness, so where can we go to not survive? Into a dream, into a virtual reality fantasy is the only place we could go, and that's nowhere at all. You're still in everywhereness. This is that. This suchness is that. This as it is now. this virtual reality as it is now. This virtual reality spaciousness as it is now. This survival game spaciousness as it is now. There's nowhere we can go where we find a survival problem. So I don't have a survival problem, I have a continuity problem. So we have to take on these challenges. We have to take on these challenges. And again, don't give up if you find it difficult. Boy, I tell you, I just had this immense struggle all day. It was just driving me nuts. I just can't seem to get it. What is going on? Just keep at it. Keep at it. It's your. Either you believe you have a survival problem, or you know that you don't. You either insist that you do, or you insist that you don't. One of the two. One of the two. You can't have a half-truth and say, well, yeah, I have a survival problem, but I don't have a survival problem. I mean, ultimately, the Holy Spirit gives us just the plausible potential for a survival problem game format, but we don't actually have any survival problem, or where we don't, but there's just a faint, plausible potential. Okay, that solves a continuity problem, but we cannot ourselves say, yeah, I have a survival problem, and also, I don't have any survival problem. Mutual exclusives. Mutual exclusives. I hope this audio is coming through here. Maybe it's not so easy. Well, just like in the world, it's not so easy. This is a good example of all this wind. The world is very windy as far as secondhand behavior goes and secondhand belief. Secondhand belief. What about secondhand belief? You're getting contaminated with secondhand belief. I'd rather have secondhand smoke over secondhand belief. What was that? Something fell. Yeah, secondhand belief is terrible. It tries to convince you have a survival problem when you don't. How terrible is that? How terrible is that? Yeah, terrible, 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 terrible. But that's never addressed, right? In fact, that's celebrated. Let's go to school and get taught that we have a survival problem. So the wind is like this secondhand belief. It just everywhere. It's just whoa, like a storming, getting worse all the time. And we're trying to assert in the face of all this noise that's in our mind, in our belief system. We're trying to say, no, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. And the wind is blowing, storming, and we're struggling. Get so distracted by, oh my gosh, look at all this, you know, this terrible storm. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Again, it's easy to do when it's all quiet and calm, but what about when the wind is roaring? Stuff's falling down. That's what's going to happen in the world. That's what will happen. And so when everything's falling down, the civilization collapsing, we would say, I don't have a survival problem. I do not have any survival problem. I do not have a survival problem. I have only one problem. That's the continuity problem, and I love the continuity problem, which is resolved by the Holy Spirit, vision of oneness of the Holy Spirit, this wonderful vision of oneness. So I'm practicing this table spaciousness as it is that, this is that, this table spaciousness as it is now, and then you get to practice with everything you're seeing, experiencing, you get to practice and practice, which is, it feels great when you're doing it. But then when you slip away, it feels terrible. Well, what happened to it? Well, where'd it go? Back into survival thoughts. Why am I not practicing? Oh, I've got survival concerns. Okay, well, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem. I only have one problem, and that's the continuity problem. That's the only problem I have. I don't have any other problem. I don't have any other problem. I don't have a survival problem. I don't have a survival problem. plain and simple, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Thank you very much. This is that. Now is now. Now is now. That is that. This is this. This is this. This is this. This is this. This is now. Now 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 is now. So that when you do that, it's great. It's wonderful. But why do we slip away? Why do we fall away? What happens is we say, oh, I fell away, it's not stable, and then back into survival, thoughts, and you're gone again. Again, thoughts, thinking, words, concepts are part of the survival game. That nowness, thisness, nowness, isness, is everywhereness, doesn't have any thoughts about everywhereness, doesn't have some survival game, doesn't need commentary, our thinking, our words, doesn't need any words at all around it. So here's the start. Okay, why am I not practicing practice if I have survival thoughts? I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Preoccupied with survival thoughts. Okay, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. So I'm getting better at it. You see, I'm getting better. But, just so you know that no matter who you are or how much you've practiced or whatever, you know, you're going to stumble. You're going to have challenges that you're just going to stumble. You're going to stumble a lot. And that's just normal. Don't think, oh, there's something wrong with me. I can't do this. I'm stumbling. I can't do this. No, that's exactly the fact that you're stumbling means you're tackling something really, really challenging. So that means you must have the right stuff. The inner guru is giving you something challenging, saying you got the right stuff. Come on, let's try this real hard one. Let's get this really tough one. So just stay tough. The location of this storm spaciousness does not matter. This storm spaciousness, as it is this, is that, is now. This location, the location of this storm spaciousness does not matter. This storm spaciousness, as it is now. This storm spaciousness, as it is that. It is that. That spaciousness. It is that spaciousness. It is this spaciousness. It is that spaciousness. This is that. This is that. And you say, oh, okay. No, survival thoughts. Oh, survival story. Lost in survival thoughts. Oh, why am I lost? Why am I not practicing? Oh, concerned with survival thoughts. Oh, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. Why am I concerned with survival thoughts? I don't have a survival problem. Again, so, this is showing, this is the practice. All day long I've been doing this, all day long. And yesterday too, today's, even fiercer battle. It's a fierce battle, actually, that's going on. For my breath, a fierce battle for my breath. For breath. When the ego controls breath, your breath, then it uses it to give you survival thoughts. It does. It somehow uses your breath, holds your breath, and just think, oh, you're not going to be able to breathe unless you think that this thought. And it literally causes you fear. It uses your controlling your breath to bring you fear and fearful thoughts, etc. That's why I think the breath of God, God has a breath for us. The breath of God frees us from the breath of the ego. So practice can be a struggle. Practice can be a battle. That's fine. That's fine. That's good. That's fine. So, I don't have a survival problem. I have a continuity problem. See? Good luck practicing. Success, much success practicing this. And try to practice it, because the storm is coming. All right? The storm is on its way. That's it.